What's up, everyone? Welcome to this video. So today we're going to look at how we can configure delete behavior in a one-to-many relationship using SQLAlchemy. Now, this is going to be a video where I'll be demonstrating how we can use a one-to-many relationship to basically go ahead and configure delete behavior between parent and child tables. Now let's get started. So the first thing you have to do is to check if you have SQLAlchemy installed, which you can go ahead and install with pip install SQLAlchemy. Now turns out I have it installed on my system, so I'm just going to go ahead and use that. But we're using SQLAlchemy 2.0 in this video. So the first thing is always going to be for us to create some database models. Now what I'll do is to create a new file. I'm going to call this my models.py. Within models.py, I'm going to begin by, first of all, creating our database tables. But all database tables are going to inherit from a certain class, which is going to be our base class. Now, all I have to do is to create a new file right here, and I'll call this file main.py. And within main.py, I'm going to begin by, first of all, creating our base class. Now, SQLAlchemy 2.0 or 2.0 provides for us the declarative base class that helps us to create this base class. So once that is done, the next thing is going to be for us to import that in our models. And once we've been able to import our base class, the next thing is going to be for us to go ahead and use our base class to create our database models. Now I'm going to be using a simple one-to-many relationship between a table that's going to be named the parent table and another table that's going to be named the children table. So to do that, what I'm going to begin doing is to first of all create the classes. And once we've been able to do that, the next thing is going to be for us to give these tables names. Now to give a table a name in SQLAlchemy, all we have to do is to provide the dunder table name. So let's go ahead and define some attributes on this table. So we're going to begin by our parent, so shall come right here, and we shall have to provide an ID. Now using SQLAlchemy 2.0, we define our tables using type hints. So to do that, what we're going to do is to go ahead and import the necessary class that's going to help us to map our attributes or fields onto their respective types. So what I have to do is to say from SQLAlchemy dot ORM, we are going to go ahead and import the mapped class, and also going to get access to the mapped column function. And what this is going to do is to help us to define extra constraints on those fields. So we need to go ahead and do that. So what shall do is to come right here, and we shall say that our ID is going to be mapped onto the integer type. Now forgive me for using integers, you can feel free to use UUIDs depending on what you need. So what shall do is to come right here and say that this is going to be our mapped column, and in here we're going to add the primary key constraint, basically stating that this is going to be our primary key. So I'll say primary key is equal to true, and I also give the table of our parent a name, and this is going to be a mapped string. And I want to also add another constraint, so this is going to be our mapped column, and what this will be is going to be nullable, so we don't want this to be null, so shall say nullable is going to be false, and this means that this should not be left null. So we can also add a dunder repre method, and what that will do is to help us to access this as a string representation, or it will help us to access every parent object in a human readable string representation. So therefore what I'll do is to come right here and define it as dunder repre, and this will take in self, and what this will do is to simply return a string of an object. So in this case, what shall do is to basically say this is going to be a parent and want to return the name of that parent, so shall say self.name. And once we've been able to do this, then we're going to do the same thing for our children class. Now we need to copy some of the fields that we have here because they are going to be similar to what we shall have on our children. So I'll just go ahead and copy this and then I'll paste it right here. So Once we have this, then the next thing is going to be for us to basically form some type of relationship between these two tables. Now what we're going to do is to add another column on our child table or our children table, and that is going to be the parent ID field. And what that will be is the foreign key that's going to point to the parent to whom a certain child is associated. So to do that, we shall say is parent, and then we have to define this as our foreign key. So I'll do this to go at the top right here and import the foreign class. So I'll say from SQLAlchemy, we are going to go ahead and import our foreign key. And once we've done that, then we're simply going to come right here and say that this is going to be our foreign key. And we have to point to where that's going to reference. So for us to do that, what we're going to go ahead and do is to simply come and look at our table name, which is parents. So that would be parents dot the field that we want to basically refer to, which is our ID. Now the next thing is going to be for us to describe how we're going to access child objects from our parent class. Now that's going to be done by setting up a relationship, which is basically one way that SQLAlchemy helps us to basically reversely access objects that are related. Now in this example, we may have something like a child. So let me just give an example right here. So we may have a simple parent object, and this parent object may have various children. So you may want to do something like parent.children, and SQLAlchemy will provide for us a way to retrieve all the children that are going to be associated to this parent via this reverse relationship. So let's go ahead and set up one. So what shall do is to come on our parent class right here, and all we have to do is to define our parent or our child attribute or our children attribute. So children is going to be, so we have to define how we're going to access this. So we may want to access this as a list, but we may want to access them as a list of children. So what we shall have to do is to describe that we want to access all the children that are associated to a parent as a list of child objects. So lucky for us, we have the list class from typing that will help us to define this list of child elements or child objects. So what I'll do is to go ahead and import the list type, and once we've been able to import that, I'll simply come right here, and all I have to do is to say list. And this list is also going to be a list of something, so we have to describe the type or the class of which the elements of that list will be. So in this case, that's going to be our child class, just like you see right here. And that will be enough for us to describe that this children attribute is going to be a list of child objects. But all these objects should be mapped or associated to a certain parent. So for us to be able to describe that, what we're going to do is to come right here and say that we're going to describe this as a relationship. So we shall have to go at the top right here and import the relationship function. And instead of being a marked column, this will be a relationship. And this relationship is going to be, so we shall have to first define which class we are going to have a relationship to. And in this case, this is going to be our child class. And then we shall have to provide other attributes. So in here, in case we want to basically find out or basically create the back reference or the reverse relationship, then you have to go ahead and say backref. And in here, what you shall have to specify is how we want to access our parent from the children. So in case we have a child object, all we have to do is to say child.parent, and then we shall be able to access that specific parent object that's associated with that child. So if I come right here and say backref equals, all I have to do is to provide parent, and that will mean that for every child object we shall have, we shall be able to access the parent as long as it's associated to one using child.parent. So let's go ahead and try to also configure our delete behavior. So to configure delete behavior, all we have to do is to add another argument, and this is going to be the cascade argument. So this is going to take in the following values. It's going to take in cascade all, and what this means that whenever we have our parent object being associated to children objects, for as long as we delete the parent, then we shall have to also mark the child objects for deletion. Now, for us to be able to delete those, all we have to do is to go ahead and add the following. So shall add the following to our cascade. So we are also going to go ahead and specify that we shall delete all child objects that are attached to this relationship. Once we've been able to do that, then the next thing is going to be for us to go ahead and basically create these tables in our database. So at this point, we only have database tables or database models, but we don't have a database yet. So for us to create one, all you have to do is to first create an engine object. And once you've imported the create engine function, we are going to go right here and create our engine object. I'll also specify echo to be equal to true, because we may want to go ahead and basically log any SQL that may be carried out, just in case we carry out some sort of transaction in our database. So once this is done, we shall also need to basically attach our base class, or be able to use our base class with our engine object to create our tables. Now create another module right here, or another file, and I'm going to call this create db.py. So in create db.py, I'll begin by first of all importing our base class, and for us to be able to create the tables in our database, shall also need to import them. So I'll come right here and say, and once we've been able to import those, then we're going to use our base class to go ahead and create these tables. So for us to be able to do that, I'll just simply call base.metadata.createAll. And in this case, we shall have to bind it to an engine. So we shall have to specify which database we want to create this in. So I'll just point it to our engine object. And that will be enough for us to create our simple database. So I'm going to pull up my terminal right here. And all I have to do is to run Python create db.py. And that will be just enough to create our database tables. I'm going to pull up my DB browser for SQLite so that you can be able to see the kind of database that we've created. So I'll pull it up right here. I'll have to basically open our database. So I'll navigate to where we created it. So our sample.db is here. So if I open it, we shall now see that our two tables have been created, which are our children and our parent tables. So once those are created, we can also be able to browse some data, which we haven't created yet, but we can simply go ahead and do that. So we're going to create a simple file right here, and this is going to be populate.py. So what I'm going to do is to create a bunch of parent objects and a bunch of children objects using our relationship. To confirm, we can go back to our database right here, and if we refresh and go back to our children, we will now see that our children have been created and they are all associated to their specific parent, which is P1. Now the reason as to why this video has been recorded is because we want to explore how to delete these objects. So to do that, what I'm going to do is to go right here and create a new file. I'll call this delete.py, and within delete.py we are simply going to go ahead and delete some of the objects that we have or that are established within our relationship. So I'm going to begin by importing our db. So I'll just come and say from main we are going to import our db object, And what this is going to do is to help us to delete. So I'll come right here and basically use some other queries we've used here. So all I have to do is to come right here and say, let's say I'll call our parent right here. And this will be able to help us to access. So we actually need to also import some of the things we imported here for this to work. So I'll go ahead and add them right here. So once we have the parent object right here, all we want to do is to first of all delete it, and that will also be able to mark our child objects for deletion. So if we come and use our session, so in this case shall say our session, which is our db object, so in this case shall say db.delete, and in this case we want to delete our instance, which is going to be our p1 object. In this case, if we call db.commit, that will be enough for us to delete our parent. So let's notice what is going to happen. So if I pull up my terminal and run python delete.py, we shall notice that our delete statement is going to be run. And the first thing that will happen is we are going to run a bunch of select statements because we have some sort of like code we are executing from other files. But this is simply what's going to happen. We are going to go ahead and first of all select the parent which we want to delete, which we are actually doing right here. And then after selecting the parent, we're also going to go ahead and delete the parent and also get rid of the children that are associated with that parent. Now to confirm that, if we go back to our database right here, we are going to refresh and shall notice that all the children that are going to be associated to the P1 parent are going to be deleted with the parent. So basically what that means is when you delete P1, you're basically getting rid of all the children objects that are going to be associated to the parent class or the parent object. So that's it all for now, and that's what I wanted to show in this video. All we have to do is to add cascade equals all in our models, and then you have to add delete, meaning that we want to delete all the child objects that are related to the parent object, just like you see in this example. If you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like and do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.